for the water sector, European technology platforms have been initiated in 2004 by the European Commission, to promote coordination and collaboration on a specific sector, so in our case, our industry, so in our case, the water sector, with regard to research, technology development and innovation. In addition, we try to promote the competitiveness of the water sector towards other global regions in the world. And last but not least, we try to contribute to solving the main water-related European challenges, and especially the main societal challenges. And societal challenges is European jargon for saying the main policy challenges that the European Commission has identified for a specific sector, which, for example, in our case, are climate change, water scarcity and drought, etc. We are a European-led platform, and as that, we are also originally set up to represent, I would say, the industrial perspective with regard to innovation and technology development in the water sector. We believe that the EIP can do something which we as WSTP can't do, which is they can reach out to a much broader diversity of stakeholders than we can do. I mean, WSTP represents, I would say, the main industrial stakeholders which have water at the core of their business model. We represent the research institutes, the utilities, both public and private. We represent, I would say, the supply chain, so the technology developers, SMEs, membrane developers, pump developers, etc., etc., and the large industrial water users like Dow Chemical, Shell, these kind of companies, Procter & Gamble. But what we don't have as an industry-led platform is, I would say, big stakeholders such as governments. The EIP has all the key stakeholders in place in their steering group. It has relevant national ministers, it had relevant commissioners, it has relevant CEOs, leaders of research institutes. These are all people which are critical to address barriers and bottlenecks with regard to innovation on water, especially because water is not a very strong issue on a European level, so you need that kind of coordination on a top level to try to address these barriers.